Hey Uncle Nick, look what we got in the shop. So we got something special in the shop right now. Rocco brought over his 1969 Ford Fairlane. This was passed down from Uncle Nick. The beauty of this car is this car has been in the family since new and just been passed down and passed down. And it's an honor whenever you get to work on vehicles like this because the owners are trusting you. I've worked on three of the family vehicles to pretty much audition for this build because they needed to know that it's going to be in the utmost care and we're going to give it that treatment. So this is going to be kind of a two-stage kind of build. So we're going to do several videos on this one, what we're doing. And we're basically going to do a very solid wire job and we're going to add speakers, amplifiers, but we're going to hide it all because they want to have tunes in this. Now, some people might, the purists are going to be like, you can't modify the car. We don't care about that. We want to make sure that the car, one, the install is reversible, and two, that we keep the car looking era, like true to its era. So we don't want to see anything. We just want to hear the music. And that's what we're here to do today. The reason why I'm saying that this is a two-stage process is because we're not going to do any fabrication as far as looks go, but it doesn't matter if you do a basic sound system or if you're going to do a really nice custom sound system, the foundation of wiring is going to be the same. So it's going to be nice for you guys. You're going to see, for those of you that want to work on your muscle cars and then you want to add sound to it, what does it take to get modern electronics into these things, which doesn't take much, and then what does it take to make it look better on the next set? Now we have to keep in mind, this vehicle's from 1969. They didn't intend for it to have amplifiers or other electronics. So one of the top things that you have to do is you have to change out your alternator, preferably with something that has higher output, and also put in a modern style battery. Now we went with North Star because what I like about the North Star is the way that's constructed. It's a low resistance battery, you can deep cycle. So it can take a lot of abuse because think about it, a vehicle that does not get driven every day, as far as the charging system goes, gets abused quite a bit because we have to, if we don't keep it on a trickle charger, the alternator is going to have to work harder to recharge that battery because we're not driving this thing every single day. Remember, the alternator is a maintenance device. So yes, they do keep it on a trickle charger, which is good, but some of you, you know, you might let the car sit for, you know, 3 or 4 days. This depletes a little bit. There is a security system in this vehicle, so we want to make sure that everything flows really good. Also, by adding that sound system, we're going to draw hard off of the battery and the alternator, so we need to make sure that that alternator can keep up with everything. So I'm glad the car finally made its way over to me. Now, they saw how I wire all the other vehicles, like the Focus, the F350, and also the F150 FX2. So they know that we can do a really good wiring job. So you can see here, the car has been worked on by several people over the years, and it's held up, but now we're in an age where wiring cleanliness can be achieved quite easily, and we know how to do it, like in the industry, obviously. So we're going to give our wire treatment to this vehicle and we're going to actually remove the head unit away from here because one, it's getting in the way by the accelerator. So you kind of have to like shimmy your foot in there. It's taking away from the drivability of the vehicle. So with modern head units, we have Bluetooth capabilities now, so we can do everything off the phone. So we're going to put a new head unit in. We're going to relocate it. They're cool with me modifying the back portion of the glove box. I don't want to touch the dash. I never want to touch the dash in these vehicles because once you cut it, like, you know, that's it. So it'll have the old twin stick look, but the head unit will be hidden away over here. So we're going to go for a sleeper sound system in this thing.
About to leave, already packing, come with me. I'm not really asking, we'll get away to a place where we don't know. What we can be, life with no distractions. We'll get away. This is what we waited for.
On a side note, you know what I realize when people know how to build an engine? They actually still put the PCV system in with the breather on these old muscle cars. I am sick of seeing two breathers on each side. You guys have to keep your positive crankcase ventilation system intact. For our front stage in the car, we're going to compromise and we're going to utilize the area in the center of the dash. So it's not the best for imaging because in order to have stereo left and right, you kind of have to move the speakers further away from each other. So we're going to lose that stereo sound, but we're not going to modify the vehicle so much. And we're going to keep that factory look going. But we got to get rid of the 4x10. It's old, but we're going to keep it just so they still have it. It is the original speaker. You can see here it says Ford Motor Company underneath. And we just capped off the wires off the factory head unit. Now what we did was we made an ABS panel and I made a notch here. That way it can slip into the one stud and then I can push it up onto the other stud and secure it into place. And we have 2 4-inch speakers that are going there. So here's our mount. And you see the magnets are quite large on them. And we're gonna amplify these and giving us lots of control. All right, so day one is complete. So let's recap what we've done. So all of this came out of the car. This section over here, all of that came out of the vehicle. So we spent a lot of time doing a wire cleanup. So the trunk is nice and clean, blank slate for us. The power wires run back here. We have to still run our RCAs and speaker wires. So the Alpines are up front now. You saw that mount that I made. So they are now installed in the factory location, installed the exact same way. So it is serviceable. It's not the easiest to service, but it is serviceable. You do not have to remove the dash. You can access it from underneath. So you can see here we have our RCAs and everything dropped down, so we have to run that. Here's our speaker wires for the front speakers, and we don't have to run any more wires because we're going to hook up directly to the rear speakers on the amplifier. In here, oh, a lot of little paraphernalia. So we have our head unit relocated here. So it used to be over there. It's now over here. We have a USB over on the side. This way we can have a USB stick with music on it, or we can do Bluetooth capabilities. We did mount the microphone down here. So we do have a little bit more wire clamp to do under the dash. So we're not completely done. The alarm system, we're gonna leave it as is. The proc sensor, I think that's the only way it's gonna work. But at least now we have a nice clean dash where when you walk towards the vehicle, you can tell it's a little bit modified, but as far as the stereo system goes, it's pretty discreet. And let's go over to our underhood work. So you can see that we made an ABS mount here. So we used the existing holes and we put new bolts in and we put in an ABS mount here for our fuse holder. So it's just an L bracket using the existing holes. And then we went ahead and used clamps with rubber bushings in them. That way it doesn't chafe. And then we came down again here using the factory bolt hole, factory bolts. That way we're not adding any more holes to the vehicle. Running down low, that way we clear the hinge over here, and then it's grommet over here, and there's a factory stud here that we got to use as well. So everything is minimalistic as far as how invasive we are with the vehicle. It seems like it's invasive, but we're using factory studs, holes, and we're just running everything nicely. That way, if you really want to reverse this, this is a pretty reversible install. So stay tuned, guys, and during the week, we will do little videos of the progress of this vehicle as we go along. If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way at all times you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles. Yeah.